Hello, Flat Earth, brothers and sisters. Welcome back to my cell. Today we will watch Tet's new video, Flat Earth Video 33, The Astronaut. Please share, like, and subscribe. If you like, thank you. Tom.
Hello, I'm Sunny Williams. I'm up here on the International Space Station. So this is Node 2. This is a really cool module. And they're put together that way. They're a wall, another wall, another wall, or the ceiling. We could sort of work on a flat plane. All you have to do is turn yourself and your reference changes.
See this door? This door there. Oi, bend! Did you see? Look, bend. He kick it with his heels. Bend. Bend. It's not a trick of the light, it bend. Bend. This is not metal. What is this? Why this door open out? All the pressure is inside. Shouldn't the door close out, not open out? This is a bend. It's a bending. Look. Oh, this is really, really bad bending. The reason that they don't have tools when they go out there and they hold on like this, like we see so many times, is that all the cables are USB plug and play. So they don't need tools.
give you a demonstration of water and just how it will form a sphere and the
rolling, you stupid. I have got to carry this box.
I definitely haven't mastered it. I'll give you a try and I'll show you just how bad it is. Practice makes perfect. Practice makes perfect. Practice makes perfect.
Ah, there is the curve of the earth. Now we can all relax because the world is a globe, and we know that is for true because they show it to us on TV. So, no more questions. Everybody, go back to bed. Everything is okay.
Yeah.
And there is the globe. We can all breathe a sigh of desperate relief.
Captain Wilmer Butch.
Thank you all.
It's been great flying with you. It's been great working with you. I am ready to accept command.
Thank you, Mike.
Thank you very much, Pavel.
Спасибо, дружище.
Thank you, my great friend.
Expedition 38.
Bouncy, 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 bouncy.
It's a great joy for me to be here with you today. For me, it has been a privilege and an honor to serve as commander.
Bouncy, 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 bouncy.
So, Gennady, it's your time to be commander. I see. That's it.
Bouncy, 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 bouncy.
Hey, I'm wearing diapers, so I don't have to stop in the middle of this video. That's why I always wanted to be an astronaut, not to go to the moon, but so that I could just poop in that spacesuit, man. Astronaut Lisa Nowacki drives 900 miles wearing a diaper without stopping to kill her romantic rival. That was probably a squishy ride. I'd hate to be the first cop to frisk her. Was she driving a Prius or a Pius? No. Gotta go. My diaper's full. And I'm not wearing sponge pants.
Yummy, yummy for my fat little pig tummy.
To the airline, but just my gut inside me said, that's my dive buddy and I should be with my dive buddy. That's my dive buddy and I should be with my dive buddy. That's my dive buddy, and I should be with my dive buddy.
Now, one of the solutions that NASA came up with was really clever. The idea of, well, we need to put something that absorbs water on the back of your head. Hey, let's use a diaper. Mm-hmm. I thought that's a clever solution to this problem.
Yeah, pretty neat. They also came up with the snorkel idea, too, you know.
Hey, let's use a diaper. I thought that's a clever solution to this problem.
It's my dive buddy, and I should be with my dive
buddy. Hey, let's use a diaper. I thought that's a clever solution to
it's my dive buddy, and I should be with my dive buddy. That's my...
I'm standing on the International Space Station!
Well, not exactly. I'm standing on an underwater full-size replica of the International Space Station in a gigantic indoor swimming pool.
You gotta tell me what it's like to be in space.
What's it like to be in space? Well, it's a lot like being in the pool here. The only difference is when you turn upside down in the pool, you feel upside down. When you turn upside down in space, there is no upside down, so you don't feel that, have that sensation of blood rushing to your head, and you can't beat the view.
Yeah, I guess that's true, huh?
Out with the demo tape and polled a lot of teachers and looked into it, and people were really excited about the idea, and then Casus got excited about the idea as well, and they decided they would take all five of my children's books up to the station to be read.
Trips to Russia when Russian bear dances, I mean, it is the quintessential Russian song.
I'm Don Pettit. I'm a NASA astronaut, and I'm on the International Space Station. We're currently about 240 nautical miles above the surface of Earth. Space Station is a serious place. We're doing serious research, scientific research and engineering research. That we've got a toilet that you use, and then a machine that goes chugga 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 chug, and then you go to the galley and you make yourself a cup of coffee. And that's exactly what you are thinking it is. I want to do some physics demonstrations. Well, I'm not very good at art. It's a good thing I decided to be a scientist and an engineer instead of an artist, because I'd probably be starving by now. Okay, here is Pig. Bird had some eggs. And Pig stole the eggs. And don't ask me how I got the eggs on space station. I got a bungee spread across the hatchway. And this bungee is kind of like a slingshot when I fire them with this orbital slingshot. Launching Red Bird into space. Well, hey, we're already into space. Whoa, look at that. Whoa, all the way down. And if you understand the math, if you understand the physics, it will allow you to go out and get a neat job. A job sort of like mine, where you're an astronaut and you can fly in space. This is all that's left of Pig after Pig got exploded. And we got to see all of this in a weightless environment, which is gravity fields from planetary bodies.
Mm-hmm. as sweet as any harmony. But she blinded me with science.
She blinded me with science.
She blinded me with. Thank you.
Very nominal, remarkably good. Beautiful, really beautiful.
A Mayan elder wearing traditional Mayan garb walks into a bar. He sits down and strikes up a conversation with the bartender, and the bartender says, "Hey, you don't look like you're from around here. Where are you from?" The Mayan elder says, "Earth," and the bartender says, "So what do your people believe in?" And the Mayan elder replies, "Well, our people believe that the earth rests on a giant crocodile sitting in a lake of water lilies." And the bartender says, "Wow, that's fascinating. Tell me more." An Anishinaabe elder, wearing a traditional feathered headdress, walks into a bar. The bartender says, "Hey, partner, where are you from?" And the Anishinaabe elder says, "Around these parts." And the bartender says, "The last guy I had in here believed the earth was on a crocodile. What do your people believe in?" And the Anishinaabe elder replies, "Well, our people believe that the earth sits on the back of a giant turtle resting in a great ocean." Bartender says, "Wow, that's incredible. Tell me more." A gentleman sitting at the bar then walks up to the bartender and says, "Hey, I heard you talking with those native wisdom keepers about the earth. Do you know what I believe?" The bartender says, "No, what?" The bar patron says, "I believe that the earth is flat." The bartender says, "The earth is a ball, you idiot. Get the fuck out of my bar."
One of the things that I really like to talk about is the science that we do up on the space station. And we've got a great picture of Koichi that shows just why we do science. We do experiments up there that we cannot do down here. Down here on the ground, it would be a puddle on the ground. And so up in space, because it forms a sphere, we get to see what does water really want to do. We get to grow crystals where crystals are growing more perfectly. We get to study combustion where we're looking at candle flames that don't look like this, but actually are round and spherical. And because of that, it lets us study combustion and pollution and how things burn more efficiently up in space. So the reason we do experiments up in space is because we can do things there that we can't do down here, and because the things that we learn up there in space are things that come right back home down here to Earth. I've got a couple more pictures to show you. There's one of my favorite experiments. It looks kind of like it's really just a liquid in a container, but again, we're seeing.
Okay, here we go. I've got my yo-yo bag, and in my yo-yo bag I have a free-spinning, non-returning yo-yo. Okay, hear that? Okay, that's the sound of precision ball bearings. So here, spin a yo-yo. I'm gonna do orbit the earth. Here we go. And it's orbiting slowly, but it's spinning fast.
When I'm with you, I just got broken. broke into two. Still I call it magic when I'm next to you.
There's two, there's three. Physics involved in this.
And I can't get over.
So you have all these neat pieces of physics.
Can't get over.
It's good to understand the physics of your recreational.
Still I call
so if you like doing yo-yos, you should read up about how they work, how the physics works. You can impress people by talking about the physics of your yo-yo.
No, I don't, no,
if you're a guy,
no, I don't, no, I don't,
just think you can impress the gals by talking about the physics of how your yo-yo works. And then if you're a gal and your yo-yo, again, learn the physics. And when you talk about the physics of how the yo-yo works in addition to doing your yo-yo tricks, you can impress the guys. And of course, there's going to be some guys that won't be impressed because they don't like physics. Learn the physics of how the yo-yo works. You can talk about that.
No,
that
I don't,
you
no,
learn
I don't,
a certain amount
no,
of physics. And when you learn a technical
no,
subject like this,
true,
this
no,
is
no,
what
no,
it helps
no,
you
no,
get
no,
a good job.
Anybody else but you.
And then, of course,
no,
you have a good
no,
job,
no,
you can
no,
afford to buy these fancy yo-yos.
No,
so here we go. Let's see if I can do it again. So orbit the Earth.
Anybody else but you.
Orbit the moon. About video, so you can edit out all these fades when you goon it up, you know, and then you can make it look like you're a real.
Serious, is that not cool or what?
Drugs
really
are. Despite appearances, I'm just a dick from
Manchester,
which is
one of the driest places on the planet.
These are the scablands where geezers kick off at a moment's notice, making it the most violent place in the solar system.
So it's either death or whiskey,
but I'm lucky enough to escape. I've come to one of Earth's natural wonders.
To do something that I've always wanted to do.
I'm about to get incredibly high.
You only really need three things. First of all, you need
copious amounts of crack.
Secondly, you need
the most amazing white lines.
Bang, bang, bang. Literally hoover it up. And thirdly, you need some kind of solvent.
I think it's absolutely wonderful. Soon after the first line of speed,
you sniff a lot because your nose becomes and makes you feel like you've had a few drinks. But then, imagine this.
I got absolutely smashed on acid. It is quite incredibly beautiful.
And that's why I love physics.
But as you head towards the light, you enter a realm of giants.
It's beginning to come, the end of the world.
I
lost it very quickly. I suppose that's pretty much what most people would expect.
Eventually, though, I had the most devastating come down.
Now, I'm significantly denser
and
50 times wetter than ever. And that is one of the wonders of the solar system.
Wow.
That is amazing.
That is amazing. I know you have kids at home. How do you stay close to your kids?
Oh wow.
Wow.
That is amazing.
That is amazing.
Cassidy, how is she doing up there? What does she bring to this team at the International Space Station?
Well, first and foremost, she brings hair. Luca and I, apparently, we don't have any, and she has an abundance of...
People who had to think of something that doesn't exist in order to make a movie, Alfonso was told.
What's this? I said take only what you need to survive.
It's my industrial strength hair dryer. And I can't live without it!
Okay, princess. That's it. The fairy tale is over. Welcome to real life.
Space, her hair is short. Did NASA get scared because the women with long hair have helped wake up the public? So from now on, are the women going to have short hair? In real life, think about women in the military and how they shave their heads. In real life, an International Space Station, if you could only take sponge baths, women on their own would probably shave their heads. And if they didn't want to do that, they would probably be instructed to shave their heads. You would not go to space with this giant crazy hair that these female astronauts have shown. Can you not see what's wrong with this picture? Thank you.
yummy, yummy for my fat little pig tummy.
Wow. That is amazing. That is amazing. Wow. That is amazing. That is amazing.
The space station itself is, I like to see pictures of it. It looks to me like it's an animation, like this was a cartoon. But the space station itself is, I like to see pictures of it. It looks to me like it's an animation, like this was a cartoon. But that's a real place. I lived there for 6 months. Koichi Wakata and his crewmates have been up there for almost six as well. And it's an amazing, amazing place. People think, they feel bad for us because going to space, it's pretty small. But actually, when we're up on that space station, it's giant and huge. It's like, that picture that you saw, it's like 10 train cars all together. It's the size of a football field. So it's like train cars without, or buses without the seats in them.
Amazing. That is amazing.
Doesn't that make you feel small? Like nothing even matters. Damn.
By the way, I want to preface everything. This is preliminary data scooped with the sieve in the cacophony of the control room during the celebration, right?
Wow. That is amazing. That is amazing.
We touch, I feel a rush. We clutch, it isn't much, but it's enough to make me wonder what's in store for us. It's lust, it's torturous. You must be a sorceress, cause you just did the impossible. Gain my trust. Don't play games, it'll be dangerous if you fuck me over. Cause if I get burnt, I'ma show you what it's like to hurt. Cause I've been treated like dirt before you, and love is evil. Spell it backwards, I'll show you. Nobody knows me, I'm cold. Walk down this road all alone. It's no one's fault but my own. It's the path I've chosen to go. Frozen in snow, I show no emotion whatsoever, so don't ask me why I have no love for these motherfucking hoes. Bloodsucking succubuses, what the fuck is off with this? I've tried in this department, but I ain't had no love with this. It sucks, but it's exactly what I thought it would be like, trying to start over. I got a hole in my heart, but some kind of emotional rollercoaster. Something I won't go on, so you toy with my emotions. So it's over, it's like an explosion every time I hold you.
Bouncy, 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 bouncy.
In the
moon. I'm a spacebound rocket ship and now I'm heart's to the moon. And I baby, right at you. 250,000 miles, I'm a king, I'm a Jew. And I baby,
oh look, it's a bouncy, 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 bouncy.
I'll do whatever it takes. When I'm with you, I get the shakes. My body aches when I ain't with you, I have zero strength. There's no limit on how far I would go. No boundaries, no lengths. Why do we say that until we get that person that we think gonna be that one, and then once we get them, it's never the same. You want them when they don't want you. Soon as they do, feelings change. It's not a contest and I ain't none, no conquest for no mate. I wasn't looking when I stumbled onto you. Must have been fake. Put so much to the stake. What the fuck does it take? Let's cut to the chase. Put a door shuts in your face. Promise me if I cave and then break and leave myself open, that I won't be making a mistake. Cause
I'm a space bound rocket ship and your heart's the moon.
Months. No longer me that you want, but I love you so much it hurts. Never mistreated you once. I pour my heart out to you, let down my guard, swear to God. I'll blow my brains in your lap, lay here and die in your arms.
you squeeze until I snap your neck like a popsicle stick. An impossible reason I can think of to let you walk about this house and let you live. Tears stream down both of my cheeks. Now let you go and just give. Before I put that gun to my temple, I told you this.
And I would've did anything for you to show you how much I told you. But it's over now, it's too late to save our love. Just promise me you'll think of me every time you look up in the sky and see a star. Cause I'm a
spacebound rocket ship and love.
And in that volume, we can do science experiments. We can do all sorts of things, and we fly from place to place.
I'm being a little flip. In short, it looked extremely clean.
Study, but up in space, it's easier. And so the things that we're learning from the experiment that Karen was doing was, for example, when we're on our way to Mars, I personally would like to know how much gas we have in our tank. And if the gas is all floating, well, how are we going to know that?
Our navigation error was on the low side of our expectation, which meant that we probably had a good alignment between the celestial center sensors and the inertial sensors, the IMU. Our powered flight appears to have been excellent. If my good friend Ben Toma is in the house.
You're going to know that. Well, in the experiment Karen was doing, when we changed the angle of the container just by like 3 degrees, so small you can't even see it, all of that liquid, all of our fuel is going to be in one place in the container. That's so important to learn about. So we're learning all sorts of things that we can't hear or find out down here on the ground. And we're learning about ourselves, about our bodies, and how people live in space. Up on the space station, it's our test bed for exploration, because we are going back to the moon, to asteroids, and on to Mars, and we're not ready. We are not ready yet, and that's why we...
Is Ben in the house? So, it looked good, in short. Good and clean. And it looks, at least by my eyeball, that we landed in a nice, flat spot.
Exercise and other things. So the experiments, again, that we do up there, we're getting to understand how to do them. We're understanding more about life down here. And last but not least, I'd just like to show a picture of Koichi and his crew, because we're going to meet Koichi, but the other folks are probably pretty busy doing science experiments. But let's see. So we've got Koichi there. You see the six of them. We go up in groups of three. And then when we get up there, there'll already be three people up there. So Koichi is going to come home with his two Russian cosmonaut crewmates. And when after he lands, another three-person crew will go up and will be a six-person crew again. So at any one moment, there are always six people doing science, making amazing things happen, and being just plain old people and doing things like playing music on the space station. Great.
She turned her tender eyes to me. Sweet as any harmony, but she blinded me with science.
She blinded me with science.
She blinded me with. Thank you.
And what a bargain that we got this mission for. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen, and look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen, and look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought.
We will use
American citizen, and look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought.
You have already seen.
This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen and look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought. And look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought.
If there's anything wrong, just give me a sign.
No!
Just any kind of sign. I'll keep on the lookout for it.
Here we go.
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth. What truth? That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage. Born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind.
No, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't. No, I don't, it's true. No, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't. When anybody else but you. No, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't. No, I don't, it's true. I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't, no, I don't. When anybody else but you. Ooh.